Hi, it's Matt here from Go Green Auto. So I've just got in this Toyota Proace electric van. And if you don't know, these are the same van as a Vauxhall Vivaro, a Peugeot Expert and a Citroen Dispatch. So in this video, I'm going to talk about the scheduled charging on these because it does work a little bit different to other vehicles and the manual is rather confusing. So yeah, as I said, the manual on this is a little bit confusing. Majority of what is in this user manual doesn't actually apply to the UK spec Proace van. With these vans, there's an awful lot of kit you can get with other vans and the people carrier versions, but that is not what is sold in the UK, certainly when it's badged as a Toyota. So a lot of the things which are in this manual just do not apply to the Toyota Proace UK spec version. So on these vans, when it is the Toyota, there's very few options on it. They're pretty much the same van. Obviously you've got your two battery sizes, but there's not much choice of equipment. They've sort of specced it as one trim level. It's called the Icon, and you don't really get any options. And this is the issue. You get the standard, I think that's 7-inch stereo. And when you have that, you do not have the timed charging functionality and the preconditioning, even though there's certain references in the book that refers to it and it looks like you do get it. But in this video, I'm just going to talk about the timed or the deferred charging and show you what you do get and how it works. So on these vans, the charge port is on the front wing, and if you've got one of these, you'll notice you've got a charge timer button down there, but it does work a little bit different to a similar button on other electric vehicles. So when you plug in your type 2 charger, you've got a status light around the buttons there which tells you what's going on, and now it's flashing green and the van is charging. If I push the deferred charger button, push and hold, it's now gone solid blue, and you'll see there it shows you that's on the timer. And we have now activated deferred charging. And on these vans, what that's going to do is just going to defer the charge to midnight, and you cannot change that time. It's just going to start charging at midnight. So for most people, that's going to be okay. By that time, everyone in the house has gone to sleep. There's going to be less load on the electricity supply. The electricity is off the greener at night. But if you're on a timed tariff, for example Octopus Go, your cheap rate electricity is not going to kick in till 12:30, so the majority of your charging will be within your cheap rate period, but this is obviously going to start charging at midnight. You can, the manual says, you can actually take this into your Toyota dealer and they will change that time, so you can have that deferred time set to whatever you like, but it is just only one time period. So you could take this in and say, I want my time change from midnight to 12:30, and they will do that, but you cannot do that yourself, and there's no options to do that yourself on the stereo. The manual will also refer to using the app. It's called My Toyota, and of course there's similar versions for the Citroen, Vauxhall and Peugeot versions of this van. I've downloaded that and tried the app, but on these UK spec vans with that standard head unit, it's pretty much useless. It doesn't do anything. All you can do is book a service and subscribe to some charging scheme where you pay £5 or so a month, which I don't want. So you cannot do any scheduled charging or preconditioning, and that is because the UK spec ones have this standard head unit. To have any of that functionality, you need the better head unit, and on the Toyota Proace you don't have that option. So I hope that helps and explains what that lower button is for on these vans. This van is now charging. But for most people, it doesn't matter that these vans don't have the scheduled charging functionality, because we've all got smart chargers now. So if you've got a more modern wall charger, in this case a wall box, these all have scheduled charging built into them, which you can do via the app. So generally it's better that you do that scheduling via your charger rather than doing it in the car, because it's then tied to your premises, and when you're out and about you don't have the issue of turning off your scheduled charge when you want to get a charge on AC throughout the day when you're using public chargers. So this isn't a biggie for most people. They're probably not going to use a scheduled charger system that's built into the vehicle. You're going to do it via your charging wall unit anyway. So I hope that helps. As always, hit that thumbs button on YouTube if you found this useful, because that really does help other people find the channel. Do subscribe if you haven't, and I'll see you on the next video.